lot. Brunch with Wendy P. That's me. I thought since I have animals on my shirt that have sunglasses on, that I needed to have some sunglasses on. But as we have seen in previous episodes, it gives some of my secrets away because you can see my ring light and the window I'm looking out of. Can you see the tree? Kind of. Whoa. I promise I haven't taken any drugs today. I just am like this. Anyway, how y'all doing? Welcome to the show. Gonna do another one here. I don't think I've tuned my ukulele out. It's Natterday up in here. Thank you, Sarah. I like it. It's actually like a little large, especially in the arms. It's supposed to be short-sleeved. But I bought it extra big because I thought I could wear it like as a nightshirt that way. And I will, probably. But also, I wanted to share it with you guys. So I hope you're having a good Saturday morning weekend day. Things have been crazy here. Oh, Ariel. Hello, Ariel. Thank you. Hello, Mac. Welcome. It's been a crazy week, so we're trying to get some stuff done while also working a lot. Both Joel and I have been, Jark and I have been working a lot, like 12-hour days. It's ridiculous. But also trying to prepare for things like this and other projects that we're working on. So, but hopefully in the end,
in a hurry, always
Yes, Coop, I bought the shirt. I kind of freestyled this in my opening, but I texted this shirt to Coop and I told her to talk me out of buying it, and she was unsuccessful. So you can either thank her or blame her for this shirt happening, okay? Hello, Amy. Hello, Maxine. Welcome, welcome. Happy Saturday. Happy August. Can you guys believe it? What do you have on your apocalyptic bingo card? Okay, I'm gonna get rid of these. It's annoying me, like, how much glare there is. I might bring them back later for some another song that they feel appropriate for. So, what are you all up to on this first weekend of August in 2020 in these weird times? Do we really have to grow up? If we never do, then so what? What if I don't wanna? What if I'm just gonna stay drunk on all the years that I just wish would slow up? We can't do it over. They say it's now or never, and all we're ever getting is older. Before we get to heaven, baby, let's give them hell. They might as well, 'cause we don't know when we're done. So let's love hard, live fast, have fun. To run away forever and bring a poncho just in case it rains. That's it. That's all you need. Your cash and a poncho. Let's run away. Are you guys in? Welcome, Rhonda. You want to run away with me? Let's run away. I can't get this to work, so. What? There you go. How about we run away? To the lime tree. And then we can eat some citrus. We'll never get scurvy. Unless we become pirates. And that's your business. Worry about yourself. Spark a match and watch the candle burn. The wick runs out and then love takes its turn. On fallen angels and broken sounds. It took a while for you to find me. Cause I was hiding in the lime tree. Above the city and the rain cloud, I poked a hole and watched it drain out, drain out. Parallel to the city streets, a broken ground's beneath our feet. As we walk across the diamonds, diamonds, we know that love is always shining, shining. So save me, love, save me all the time. I'll wash it down with a simple sip of wine and toast a glass to all my loved ones to let them know that the stars, well, they still shine. Took a while for you to find me. I was hiding in the lime tree, above the city and the rain cloud. Poked a hole and watched it drain out, drain out. It took a while for you to find me. Cause I was hiding in the lime tree, above the city and the rain clouds. I poked a hole and watched it drain. Took a while for you to find me, but I was hiding in the lime tree, but the city and the rain clouds, I poked a hole and watched it drain out, it took a while for you to find me, but I was hiding in the lime tree, but the city and the rain clouds. Out of the frame, can you not hear me burp? I don't think that works really. That was mostly so you didn't have to see me with the tissue. So welcome everybody. It's a time, what a time to be alive, I'll tell you what. It's also, actually today, it is Bummer Karaoke Day. Bummer karaoke time! Today it is a bummer. I'm feeling very emo today. Moody. Is that what the kids are calling it these days? I don't know. Anyway, this is a song by one of my all-time favorite songwriters who I've seen in concert about a bajillion times, with mostly with my cousin Denise. Shout out to Denise if you're out there. I think that they're on vacation still, lucky ducks. But I will get to have a mini vacation next week with the fam at Rathbun. We're gonna go on a boat again. What? All right, anyway, this song is called Apologies by Grace Potter. She's fantastic if you are not familiar with her work. She writes, I believe, most of her own songs. And she's a... I love her. And hopefully I'll do the song justice for y'all. Yesterday he said my eyes were fading away. He said, well, what do you expect? You asked me not to stay. And if it had all been for the best, I wouldn't feel this way. He said, gets a little bit too warm. Sometimes I want to wrap somebody in it who can hold me in his arms. Cause when it got a little too hot in there, he was always stepping out for air and he froze. Oh, he froze. Stays with me, yeah. You know, and it hurts me, cause I don't wanna fight this war, and it's amazing to see me reading through this scene of love and fear, and yesterday he looked at me with a tear in his eye. He said, I always tell you you're my friend. I hope I don't have to lie, cause it's clear you love another man. I said, you're damn right. He said, oh, he said. Alright, broke the tension with the fire piano. Anyway, that one is very tough to sing. Okay, there we go. So, I don't know if I'll ever be able to multitask with that little ditty, but... I love it. And I highly recommend, if you ever get a chance to see Grace Potter live, do it. She's a very, very energetic, dances around. She doesn't wear that many clothes if you're into that. Here's another one of my favorite songwriters. I've already done a couple of hers today. Let's do another one. Concrete. Oh, well, I'm glad I could get James' attention by saying that Grace Potter doesn't wear very many clothes on stage, which is true, and she almost always comes on stage with high heels and some kind of jacket, and then loses those too. At least every time I've seen her. But it's also been in the middle of summer. And last time, Denise, my cousin, and I went to go see her, it was like 100 degrees, literally. Not even the heat index. Had a couple people pass out. So I don't blame her for not wearing a lot of clothes on stage that day. Another person who doesn't wear that many clothes on stage is Casey Musgraves. You know, hey, if you got it. Last time I saw her, she had on really cute little tiny shorts. So, James. That's how you get him to go to a country show like Casey Musgraves or Grace Potter's kind of country. Tell them little tiny shiny shorts. That's the outfit. That is not the outfit at my shows. I've lost my set list, you guys. Where'd it go? They're under my shiny shorts. These shiny shorts, they don't have any pockets, so I can't keep my set list in there. As far as I know, John Anderson does not wear shiny little shorts on stage, but I can't say that for sure. Excuse me. Because I've never seen him. I'd love to, though. Anyway. How about one from him? Alright, hold on. We're having a capo issue, it makes it sound weird. The black. tell John Anderson is in heaven listening with shiny shorts on. I didn't know that he had passed away. Was it recently? Or has he been gone for a while and that's why it's not registering me? I mean, I knew he wasn't like actively touring anymore, but I guess I didn't know he had passed away. Bummer. Anyway. Bummer karaoke time. Talking about dead people. Let's do a different one. I don't think this person is dead. She is young. She might wear shiny shorts. When she performs, this is a song from Cam. Are sticky things to go on choosing on your soul. Rearrange your dreams. You get so good at climbing, you stop asking where it leads on this road to happiness. It's the wild unknown, it's the ball and chain, it's unknown destination, we keep driving anyway. Is the future that we're chasing worth the right now that we miss this road to happiness? I'm taking time to ask myself just where I wanna be. Does the flower growing in the ground worry just like me? Or does he love the sun so much that he don't mind the weeds on this road to happiness? Future that we're chasing worth the right now that we miss on this road to happiness. We brought him back to life. John Anderson is alive. It's the wild unknown, it's a ball and chain, it's a knowing destination, we keep driving anyway. Is the future that we're chasing worth the right nows that we miss on this road to happiness? Be careful who you hang around, beliefs are sticky things. It's a wild unknown, it's a ball and chain, it's a knowing destination, keep driving anyway. Is the future that we're chasing worth the right nows that we miss on this road to happiness? Well, I'm so happy to hear that John Anderson is still alive and thriving in Florida. Watch out for the Rona down there. John Anderson, if this reaches you, we will be loving you and we want you to stay alive. He's only 65. I would have guessed maybe he was older than that, but Willie is older than that. Did any of you guys watch his birthday thing. It was during, when Iowa and a lot of us were real locked down. That was pretty cool. Actually, it was a big inspiration for me wanting to start doing this because I was like, shit. All these famous people can play out of their bedrooms and mess up their songs in front of millions of people. I can do it in front of you. Anyway, so peace to Willie and John Anderson out there. Hello? Where's my dog going? No?
It's delicious.
Oh, but it's not. What do you mean it's not good?
You don't have a taste.
Oh, I always forget that it's backwards. I can't.
It's almost there.
Oh. That. That. I can't even describe what just happened. It tasted like a very alcoholic smoothie, but like, you know when you get a malt somewhere and it's so thick that you have to like really try to get it out of the straw? That's what that was like, but at the end it was vodka.
Those used to be gummy bears.
Yeah, you can, it's glary with that light.
Very reflective. It's kind of pretty.
Anyway. I don't know how to do that. Anyway, so we, Jark, he made some vodka gummy bears, but I guess we didn't buy the right kind because they became gummy bear slush.
Goo.
It's pretty nasty. I mean, the flavor's okay, but the texture is real gross. Yeah.
They're boogers.
It'll do the job though, you know. I'm not gonna waste it. We'll experiment some more. Maybe we'll get some like high
name brand
stuff. Yeah, at least not the Fleet Farm bulk gummy bears that we got. Disclaimer. Those don't work if you wanna make a churl. That's a pretty good description. All the colors mixed together and it made black. So that's what's up with that. So what are all you drinking? I bet none of you are drinking vodka, gummy bear, smoothies. Probably. I mean, go out and make one if that's your thing, you know, but... Alright, so I think this is going to be my last one. I know it's a little short today, but we got stuff to do. It's a beautiful day. You can go out and enjoy yourself. When I started this whole thing, I thought I would only play for half an hour. Just like real, because I didn't think anybody would want to watch for a whole hour. But then the first one went on so long, so quickly, over an hour. So now I've kind of been shooting for that. But there's no rules on the internet. I can end at 50 minutes if I want to. And I might leave room for commercials when this becomes a TV show. So, I'll do one more. And then we'll be out of here. Instead of the gas, caught in. Fan of Your Life. But not troll. Diarrhea. Alright, everybody. Thank you for tuning in. So you can look at my sweet ass shirt. I love you all so, so very much. If you so feel inclined to give me money, virtual tip jar, I've got three ways, depending on whatever platform that you like to use. I'm going to put it towards doing more cool stuff here. So, yeah. I love you. Thank you for tuning in. One last disclaimer. No lunch. No brunch with Wendy P next week. I am going to be out camping and not have enough of a signal, I think, to do it. Plus, I'm going to be with my family. I want to just hang out with them, you know? So, I will not be here next week. But I should be back after that to resume the fun. Love you guys very much.